three straight since the trade deadline. Shannon, what do you expect tonight?
I expect more of what I've been seeing the last two games in Atlanta. Don't you skip? Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, that old young bench. Mm-hmm. That, oh, man. Mm. Man, Kobe, you did an unbelievable job. Kobe Altman, the way he pulled that thing off.
He's the new Kobe? Yeah,
yeah. I don't know how he pulled that off. Get rid of all those old pieces and got us some new spare parts. Woo, that's all Bron needs. Mm. And you know when Bron is, like, happy, reinvigorated.
He looks like he is.
Somebody in a heap of trouble. Mm. Bench scored about 50 points a game. Now, look, last year that was a weakness. Mm-hmm. Rodney Hood coming off the bench. Clarkson, instant offense. You got Larry Nance Jr. who can play major minutes for you, but coming off the bench. Ooh, Skip, you know what's going to happen. We're going to keep this thing rolling. Rolling, rolling, rolling. Rolling, rolling, rolling. Jordan, you know Big Wheel, you know me.
Are we getting this on tape?
Oh, rolling. Yeah. Oh, you think we're going to lose?
Is it rolling as in tape is rolling?
Rolling. Okay. Oh, roll high.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
how do you know roll
high? Don't worry about all that.
That's way before my time. How do you know these shows?
I know about it sometimes. Huh? But look, JR has all of a sudden found his stroke. They got guys that's coming off the bench, and that's what LeBron likes. LeBron likes spot-up shooter, Skip. So, hey, he's going to be able to get to – he and Larry Nance with those shooters. Mm. Jeff Green is all – you know, count on what – oh, Jeff Green.
You know what? He's been the best Cavalier this whole year to me, outside of LeBron. Okay. Seriously.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, he's been really good, and they kept him.
Yeah.
And they kept JR, and they kept Tristan. And Kevin Love is going to come back. Not tonight, but he's on his way back in a couple of weeks. Fourth Corver is still there.
And then, you know, Skip, I don't know if it's true, but they say every time he hit a three, that's what comes on the intercom.
Okay, that's fine. All right, way to go. So, the Washington Wizards are 7-2 in their last nine games without John Wall, who obviously had a little knee scope.
You hear that, John Wall?
Yeah. Okay, and Bradley Beal has been looking like he's equal of John Wall.
He's an all-star.
Yeah, he's an all-star. So, this is kind of an interesting game because in Washington recently, these Wizards beat Oklahoma City and they beat Toronto. Pretty nice wins at home. This one's in Cleveland. Cleveland is favored by a grand total of 5.5 points, and I want me some of this. If I were a betting man, I'd put a whole bunch of money on this because Cleveland's going to win this game by a whole lot more than 5.5.
Oh, I thought you were about to say, oh, you
want. No, I want to bet on your team.
Oh, okay.
I want to put a whole lot of money on this because I'm going to guess the Cavs will win this game like 120-99. It will be a blowout.
Dang.
It will be over after three quarters.
I don't like it. I don't
LeBron,
like it.
LeBron should be resting in the fourth quarter of this one.
See, Joe, you see what he's doing?
I'm not doing anything.
I know what you're doing, Skip Bayless.
I'm doing what my eyes tell me to do, and I saw the new Cavaliers go destroy Boston in Boston.
Yeah.
You saw it, too. And I saw them go to Oklahoma City and turn those tables and then just beat the Thunder under that table in their home arena. Mm-hmm. Beat them up. Mm-hmm. Left them for dead. Mm-hmm. Just destroyed them after they got destroyed pre-trade.
Got some of that for
Cleveland.
Baby dinosaurs, too, next time we see them.
Okay, all right. There you go. So what have your eyes told you? That, man, I love LeBron's new team. You do, too.
My eyes told me that LeBron is the best player in the NBA. That would have been telling me for the last 15 years.
All right, so I'll give you that now. I'll give you because he is reinvigorated, recharged. Here he comes out of All-Star break. They have outrageous days off. They all get like a week off. Obviously, the All-Stars have to go participate. But this has been a long break.
But he went to Cancun. He went to Cabo. He went to one of them here in Savannah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Did you arrange it? Or?
No, I'm just saying, you know, he went, you know, blow off a little steam. You know, I saw him on Insta Live. You know, he had his feet up there talking about.
So, I'm going to say it again. There are no more excuses for LeBron James. No more. You don't need any.
No.
You don't deserve any.
No.
Because I love this team. And I'm just telling you from my heart, I love what I see. All the pieces fell right in place. Because in place of Isaiah Thomas, me, myself, and Isaiah, you get two of the most explosive scorers off the bench in the NBA. So they fit right into the roles that you need them to fit into.
Say it again. Roles. They know their roles.
Roles. They do.
Somebody came in there thinking he was going to come in there average 30. And he was shooting like he was trying to get 30. Wasn't drawing nothing.
And guess what? He is now a Los Angeles Laker.
Yeah.
Way to go, Kobe Altman. So Cleveland's Kobe sent him to what used to be LA's Kobe, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the decks got cleared. There's no more Jay Crowder. There's no more Derrick Rose. There's no more Dwayne to have to juggle the ego of Dwayne. We love you, Dwayne, but we can't find enough minutes for you. Dwayne got to go home.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Because, Skip, when you think about it, if you try to run the second unit, Isaiah needs the ball, Derrick Rose needs the ball, D-Wade needs the ball.
I agree.
When you can't have three ball-dominant guys running
you
the
cannot.
Second unit. So guess what we're going to do? We're going to give you guys an opportunity to go play somewhere. You can run the second unit, and you can all have the ball.
Yeah.
But it's amazing.
And you have to remember, Jordan Clarkson's a big guard. Rodney Hood's a really big. He's 6'8".
Yeah.
And both of them, if pressed, if they're in the right space and mood, they will defend. They'll defend at a high level. And Larry Nance Jr. will really defend at a high level.
Rebound.
So all of a sudden, and George Hill is just a player. He's a pro's pro. I'm not saying he's a star, but he will defend his position.
Yeah.
And he can defend a one or a two. Mm-hmm. What's not to like about those? The fit of this?
And then I got that
it's
guy.
Beautiful.
I got that guy.
You got that guy. Okay, so he should be re-energized after he had the worst stretch of his whole career.
Yeah, he had the worst
19 games in which his plus-minus was at the bottom of the barrel. 518 NBA players. He was 518th for a whole 19-game stretch. That's almost one-fourth of the year. So now the world just turned.
What about all those albatrosses that was around his neck?
He had one, big one.
Had a bunch of them.
Yeah, well, he had one.
Tried to carry
sure.
him.
Okay.
So now...
deck's cleared. No more excuses. Here we go.
You know, Skip, will you stop using the word excuses? We had no excuses.
Well, you had huge. You were making them every day.
First of all, and you weren't going to give him any anyway, even though you knew Isaiah Thomas wasn't a fit.
Even
though Derrick Rose wasn't a fit.
That was a bad idea. Come on. What are you?
Well, here's the thing. Well, they were thinking they were going to have Derrick Rose running the second unit with Kyrie being on the team. But once Kyrie requested the trade, because they had signed Derrick Rose before Kyrie wanted this trade. Mm. So now that upset the apple cart. But that's okay. You know, look, Bron smooth that thing on out. You know, sometimes during the cake fall, my grandma's like, I'm like, Granny, the cake. She's like, man, boy, hey, give me that pan. You know, she do that little thing, fixed it right on back up. Mm. Now LeBron, watch tonight.
Mm. I'm going to get to bed a little early tonight.
No, you ain't going to
be over. I'm going to call you. It's going to be over.
Nope.
It's a rout.
Skip, stop that.
What are you going to do, bet against your team?
No.
You're going to bet me a case of do you want?
No.
I'll give you the Wizards in 5.5.
You told me that you stay up and watch all the games. No, I need you to stay up and watch all the games.
Well, I don't need to watch. This is a rout. This is a mismatch.
Because you never know. You might see LeBron do another walk-off step back.
You know what I might see tonight if LeBron holds form? I might see him play all the way to the bitter end of a blowout just so he can get his triple-double stats.
Oh.
And we might see that for sure.
Well, you saw what happened. He had 37, 8, and 8 against the Thunder. Mm. I mean, you remember what happened last time in D.C.? He got a triple-double, and then he had that 57, 11, and 8 ball game.
Hmm.
You remember that, Skip?
Well, it's time. Here we go.
Yeah.
It's time for takeoff. They're poised for takeoff.
I mean,
right?
he'll walk in triple doves.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, you know that.
So here we go. Is he going to start making his MVP case tonight?
What do you mean start? When did he stop?
Well, he stopped for 19 games. That's a big. That's almost a fourth of the year.
I mean, he's still averaging 26 and 9 and 8.
You know, you're classic how you expunge his record. You just cleanse it.
No, that's
no matter
what's
happened in the near past or the distant past, you just sweep it away.
I just do what you do with Michael. Those last 2 years in Washington doesn't count. And the years before he won the title doesn't count.
He was great in those years.
What did he win?
Huh? He's up against three of the all-time greatest teams.
You see what I see? See what I see? You see what he did there?
Well, he was.
So let me ask you a question. Is the Warriors an all-time great team?
Yeah.
Oh, that's what LeBron's up against.
Hmm. Well, he's the best player on the planet, right?
Will Kawhi Leonard ever play for the Spurs again? We'll discuss that with Eddie House.